Hi guys, welcome back to List Cafe. Today we're going to note down the top 10 museums you should visit in Nairobi, Kenya. We'll be rating them by their reviews. Let's get straight into the video. Number 10. One-off Contemporary Art Gallery. The One-off Contemporary Art Gallery is one of the oldest and best-loved contemporary art galleries in Nairobi. The gallery is committed to exhibiting only the best art in Kenya and the region. The One-off Contemporary Art Gallery promotes East Africa's most established names. The gallery showcases a revolving exhibition featuring artwork of various renowned artists. The One-off Contemporary Art Gallery is located in Kitsuru, Nairobi City, in Nairobi County. The gallery always has a large permanent stock of paintings and sculptures. The gallery was started in 1994 and it aims to represent some of the most established artists in Kenya. The One-off Contemporary Art Gallery takes advantage of the blossoming of interest from the international art markets in works from East Africa. Number 9. Banana Hill Art Gallery. The Banana Hill Art Gallery is a lovely gallery located on the outskirts of Nairobi. It has a superb selection with over 60 local artists. The subject matter ranges from daily life in the African community to portraits, abstract art, and medieval paintings. The Banana Hill Art Gallery has an open gallery and solo exhibitions featuring local artists. The Banana Hill Art Gallery is a trend-setting gallery located on the boundaries of Nairobi, exhibiting some of East Africa's most stunning paintings and sculptures. The Banana Hill Art Gallery is located 4 kilometers along the Banana Hill Road. It's about 4 kilometers from the village market. If you have time and want to relax, visit the Banana Hill Art Gallery today and get to view some beautiful portraits from local artists in the country. The Banana Hill Art Gallery comes at number 9 on the top 10 museums you should visit in Nairobi. Number 8, the Karen Village. The Karen Art Village is an art, culture, and creative innovation hub with studios, spaces, shops, and restaurants. Karen villagers are artists, social entrepreneurs, printers, glass artists, artisans, frame sculptures, among other creative fields. The Karen Village is located between Ngong and Karen. The Karen Village considers themselves a hub for culture, art, entrepreneurial growth, and media. The aim is to raise awareness of African culture by hosting monthly cultural events. The Karen Village has artist residences and accommodation for people to come and enjoy what they have on offer, and each Karen villager holds informative and interactive workshops on what they do. This makes the Karen Village number 8 on the top 10 museums you should visit in Nairobi. Number 7, the Nairobi Gallery. The Nairobi Gallery is located at the intersection of Kenyatta Avenue and Uhuru Highway at the heart of Nairobi City. It was built in 1913. It was formerly the old PC's office building. Today, the building is a national monument and serves as a museum holding temporary art exhibitions. The building was fondly referred to as Hatches, Matches and Dispatches because of the births, marriages and deaths that were recorded there. The museum includes ancient sculptures, paintings and artifacts of daily life from diverse cultures. The museum is open daily from 8:30 a.m. to 5:30 p.m. Admission for Kenyan citizens is 150 shillings for adults and 100 shillings for children. East African citizens pay 600 for adults and 500 shillings for children. Non-residents pay 1,000 Kenya shillings for adults and 500 Kenya shillings for children. This makes Nairobi Gallery number 7 on the top 10 museums you should visit in Nairobi. Number 6, the Aero Club of East Africa. The Aero Club of East Africa was founded in Kenya in 1927. The club was built alongside Nairobi's Wilson Airport and it featured prominently in 20th century African aeronautical history. The club remains active to date and hosts facilities and events that are open to the public. The club was founded on July 31st, 1927. Its founding members include 24 pilots and aviation enthusiasts. The club provides pilots, engineers, and enthusiasts a place to gather and share stories and knowledge. They also offer basic flying instruction and host competitions, air shows, and skydiving demonstrations, and much more. Number 5, the Kenya National Archives. The Kenya National Archives is situated at the edge of the Central Business District in downtown Nairobi along Moi Avenue next to Ambassador Hotel. The archives looks out on the landmark Hilton Hotel. It was established in 1965 by an Act of Parliament of Kenya, and it was placed under the office of the Vice President and the Ministry of Home Affairs. The Kenya National Archives is open to the public during weekdays from 8 a.m. to 5 p.m. and it's open on Saturday from 8 a.m. to 12 p.m. and it's closed on Sundays. The National Archives is home to the Murumbi Gallery, located at the ground floor of the Kenya National Archives building, and is named after Joseph Murumbi, who was the second Vice President of Kenya. The Murumbi Gallery is currently the largest Pan-African gallery in Africa, and it contains ancient art collections from different regions and communities of Africa. Number 4, the Nairobi Railways Museum. The Nairobi Railways Museum is located in Nairobi, Kenya. It's adjacent to Nairobi Railway Station, and it contains exhibits from the defunct East African Railways. The museum was opened in 1971 by East African Railways and Harbours Corporation. The museum has maintained its rail connection that allows for the efficient movement of museum exhibits for maintenance and placing items in the collection. The museum has 3 operational steam locomotives, which are stored secretly undercover within the main railway works. The museum's collection also includes early diesel locomotives and passenger coaches. In January 2011, a working miniature railway was installed to enhance activity of the museum. It consists of a locomotive with a petrol engine and several coaches made of wood. The Nairobi Railway Museum is open to the public from 8 a.m. to 5 p.m., including weekends and public holidays, and that makes the Nairobi Railways Museum number 4 on the top 10 museums you should visit in Nairobi. Number 3, the Bomas of Kenya. Experience the diversity of Kenya's authentic traditional homes, music, and dances by visiting the Bomas of Kenya. You can also save authentic Kenyan cuisine in a cultural setting. The Bomas of Kenya offers a rich diversity of Kenyan traditional music and dance in their daily cultural performances. The repertoire consists of over 50 dances from ethnic communities with live percussion, string, and wind instruments. The dancers will take you on a journey through Kenya's past and present. The Bomas Harambee Dancers Resident Troupe was founded in 1973, and it was named in honor of the first president of Kenya's call for unity and cooperation in building the Kenyan nation. 4 decades later, this troupe is still active. The Bomas of Kenya also collects and preserves cultural artifacts from various communities of Kenya. It also has a library and multimedia center, which was established with the mission of disseminating research findings, assisting students and teachers and researchers in accessing information on cultural, music, dances, and practices from various ethnic groups in Kenya. It is open every day from 8 a.m. to 5 p.m., and that makes the Bomas of Kenya number 10 on the top 10 museums you should visit in Nairobi. Number 2, the Nairobi National Museum. The Nairobi National Museum tells the story of Kenya's rich heritage. The museum's mission is to collect, preserve, study, document, and present Kenya's past and present cultural and natural heritage for the purpose of enhancing knowledge, appreciation, respect of Kenya's heritage. If you happen to visit the Nairobi National Museum, don't miss to go to the whole of Kenya. The Joy Adamson Gallery, the Cycles of Life, the Birds of East African Gallery, the Great Halls of Mammals, Ahmed the Elephant, who was known for his large tusks globally, the Cradle of Mankind, and Historia Kenya, which is a temporary exhibition gallery in the museum. It's open from 8:30 a.m. to 5:30 p.m., and that makes the Nairobi National Museum number 2 on the top 10 museums you should visit in Nairobi. Number 1, the Karen Blixen Museum. The Karen Blixen Museum is located 10 kilometers outside of Nairobi, Kenya, at the foot of the Ngong Hills. The Karen Blixen Museum is the former African home of Danish author Karen Blixen, famous for a 1937 book Out of Africa, which chronicles life at the estate. After Karen Blixen's death in 1962, the house was donated by the Danish government in 1964 to the new Kenyan government as an independence gift, and it was opened to the public in 1986 as one of Kenya's national museums, following the popularity of the 1985 movie Out of Africa. The Karen Blixen Museum is open every day between 9:30 a.m. and 6 p.m., including weekends and public holidays. Visitors have the opportunity to continuously take part in guided tours of the house, and this makes the Karen Blixen Museum number one on the top 10 museums you should visit in Nairobi. Thanks for watching this video, guys. Bye!